Welcome again to this series of videos about using Yamaha network switches in Dante-based audio systems. We've been learning about how to monitor and manage your network. Now, we're going to learn how to prepare your network to be shared with non-Dante equipment and other types of data. But of course, hopefully you know that basic Dante systems don't require any special settings in a network switch. Unmanaged switches without energy-efficient Ethernet can be used. But when your network grows and additional equipment is added, there are benefits to using managed switches and making some particular settings. It may take time to learn about this for regular IT manufacturers of switches, but Yamaha makes it refreshingly easy. Back to EEE, or Energy Efficient Ethernet. It can be a useful switch feature for saving energy where it slows down data transmission at certain times. But this is not good for real-time audio, so it's recommended to disable it for Dante devices. Then there's QoS, or Quality of Service. This switch feature identifies 64 different tags that a network device may add to its transmitted data. Then, each data type is organized into a queue and assigned a priority level. The higher the priority, the sooner the data is processed and forwarded. Many switches have 4 priority levels, while the Yamaha's managed switches have 8. Anyway, Dante clock signals require the highest priority, and Dante audio the second highest. Then, there's IGMP snooping and querier. IGMP meaning Internet Group Management Protocol. This strange sounding feature is where switches spy on the data passing through them. They identify and then block multicast data from reaching places where they are not needed. Otherwise, multicast data would spread throughout the network, using up precious bandwidth. Normally, there's very little multicast data in Dante systems, but sometimes it is needed when the same audio signals need to reach many devices, like the output of a mixer reaching all the amplifiers surrounding a sports stadium. So IGMP snooping is a helpful switch feature. Note that 3 versions of IGMP exist, while Dante is compatible with versions 2 and 3 only. And make sure the same version is used throughout the network for stable operation. It's notoriously tricky to program in most IT switches, but Yamaha makes it easy and uses the newer version 3 by default. Compare an unmanaged switch with a managed one using IGMP snooping and querier. When there are 48 audio channels being transmitted multicast in the network, 100 megabit devices are overwhelmed and struggle to work correctly. However, IGMP snooping filters out the multicast transmissions from places where they are not needed, and your lower bandwidth devices can work freely again. Actually, the ideal settings for IGMP, QoS, and EEE are all enabled by default in the SWP range of switches for VLAN 1, the default VLAN. To enable them on SWR series managed switches, use the Dante optimization feature found in the web GUI management menu. Go to manual settings, click Next, and then OK. It's as simple as that. Compare the settings menu for other types of switch, where you see a table of 64 numbers to contend with, as well as a range of other baffling options. Now you can see how these switches are helpfully optimized. I've just mentioned VLANs. If you've been studying networks or completed some Dante certification training, you must have come across them already. Virtual local area networks. It's where the switches can be split into zones so different devices can be completely separated from communicating with each other. It means networks can be shared by several groups of devices without them interfering with each other, so long as the total available bandwidth isn't exceeded. So you could use one VLAN for Dante devices and another VLAN for the control of lighting equipment or video or general office IT. Each port on a switch gets assigned to a particular VLAN, and ports that are used to link with other switches can be programmed to carry multiple VLANs at the same time without the data crossing over to the wrong device group. The SWP switches make this really easy. Dante presets A, B, and C all have two VLANs, where half the ports are used for Dante in VLAN 1, while the other half are in VLAN 2, which can be used for other equipment. Perhaps wireless microphone monitoring, for example, or for controlling amplifier systems. Dante preset C makes both VLANs ready for Dante, so two separate Dante networks can be used within the same switches. Perhaps one for bringing inputs from the performance area to the mixing console, and a separate network to distribute the mixer outputs to the PA system amplifiers. Keeping them separate allows different engineers to manage and monitor them individually to minimize mistakes and to limit the effect of any fault. So it's useful having HY or MY cards for Dante, allowing mixing consoles and DSP engines to link between two or more Dante networks. On the SWR2300 switches and the SWP2 switches, there are two ways to manage VLANs. The traditional way, using tagged VLANs, which is compatible with switches from other manufacturers, or a newer, simpler method called multiple VLAN, which will suit some networks. The tagged method is used in the Dante presets for SWP switches. So let's have a look at that first. In user config mode, the web GUI can be used to create VLANs and assign them to certain ports. Open the detailed settings menu and the VLAN menu. Then select Create VLAN. You'll see there's only one VLAN in the default state of the switch. Click the New icon to create another. Give it a number and a name, such as amps, if you're going to use it to link managed amplifiers which are not equipped with Dante, for example. Then you could create a third VLAN with another name and more, as many as you need. After that, you need to assign different ports to each VLAN. Go to the Tag VLAN page, and you'll see that by default, each port is assigned to VLAN 1, and their operation mode is set to Access. This means the ports will be used to introduce new data into the network, such as from Dante devices or computers. All the data entering the switch via an Access port will join the associated VLAN, in this case, VLAN 1. Now we can assign other ports to VLAN 2 and 3 to separate their data. Check the required ports for VLAN 2, then click Specify All. Keep the operation mode as Access and set the VLAN to number 2, Amps. Confirm. Assign other ports to VLAN 3 if you wish. Now the switch is separated into three segments, and any device in VLAN 1 will not be able to communicate with devices in VLAN 2 or 3. It is as if we have three individual network switches now. If we want data from all three VLANs to reach other switches, we will now need three cables. Or if we want to use just one cable, we'll need to create a trunk. I'll describe how to do that in the next video. But now let's briefly see the alternative method of multiple VLANs. So let's select all the ports and return to defaults. And now everything is back in VLAN 1. So open the multiple VLAN page, and here we can create groups of ports that we want to work together. For example, use ports 1 to 6 for Dante, 7 to 12 for amps, and 13 to 18 for office equipment. So select ports 1 to 6 and specify all. Select group 1 and confirm. You can assign ports to multiple groups easily if you want one computer to monitor all the devices, for example. This allows all the devices to use the same subnet or range of IP addresses while keeping their communication data separate. So this method is quicker to implement and perhaps easier to understand, but it can only be used with these newer Yamaha SWR and SWP2 managed switches. It's not available with the SWP1. So, using VLANs can save the cost of purchasing additional switches to handle extra data. A switch with many ports divided into VLANs will be more efficient than using many small individual switches. The SWP switches have a really helpful front panel feature for VLANs. It displays the VLAN settings with the port LEDs using color coding. For example, no lights will indicate VLAN 1. A green light will indicate the second VLAN. An orange light will indicate the third VLAN. And two orange lights will indicate a trunk carrying two or more VLANs together. In the next video, I'll show you how to link multiple switches into one network and how to share the VLANs throughout the system. You will learn about trunks and link aggregation. See you then.